小什么？Sisters that I didn't see this morning. Amen. It's good to see faces I did see this morning. Amen. Some I hadn't seen in a while. Some I hadn't seen in a week or two or months. And some I hadn't seen in an hour or two. Amen. Feel free to praise the Lord. Feel free to worship the Lord. Feel free to get a blessing. Amen. And don't be afraid. If you need prayer, know that the Lord is already there. Amen, somebody. Praise God. Hallelujah. As we open up service, Father God, we give it to you. Lord, use us as you see fit, as willing vessels, Lord. Bless everybody in the house, Lord Jesus. Oh, Father God, do that thing that only you can do. Heal the sick. Cleanse the lepers, raise the dead. We give you praise, we give you thanks, we give you glory and honor. Now forevermore, use us mightily, Holy Ghost, in this service to you. Oh, we praise you. We just want to praise you. We just want to thank you. We come looking for strength. We come looking for blessings. We come looking for healing. We come looking for salvation. And we come to you, Master. The right place at the right time. In Jesus' name, we open this service to you. Amen and amen. Turn your attention to the screen. Praise God. Revelation Fireside. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Every place where the war is right now, we were there for Worldwide Vision Day. In the largest church in Europe, the largest church in Ukraine. Somebody praise God. Hallelujah. I saw a video with him. We were there preaching and releasing Worldwide Vision Day. Show a little piece of that clip if you think I'm joking. Somebody praise God. Hallelujah. We are there. We're the war is now. We're the war is now. In kind, we were there.
We are going to praise God. Somebody say praise. Heading into Ukraine on WWE. Worldwide.
Jesus.
Not saved, it's time to get saved. Amen. The water is a type of the Holy Ghost, and he ministered tonight to cause you, if you're not saved, to turn to Christ. To turn to Christ, the convicting power of God. As the woman of God speak, my God, it's every unbeliever need to come to Christ. Mm-hmm. When the word go forth about the water. About the water. So first of all, tonight, if there's anybody here not safe, the water is available. Come to the waters. Come to the waters. Is there one tonight who not saved? If you're here tonight and you're not saved, we'll pray with you. We'll pray with you. Just brave it and come and stand right here. I'm going to pray with you. And in a couple minutes, you will be all the way. You'll be all the way. You would have dedicated the waters of your life. Anybody here? Will you come? Will you come? Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Come, watch me. To Jesus right now. He will say, He will say, is there one among us? Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus right. He will say, He will save you tonight. That door remains open, and any time before we close, you can come and say, pray with me.
Yes.
Because I want class.
Pray.
I gotta deal with my water.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You gotta listen good. When the word of God go operate in a prophetic atmosphere, you gotta go beyond just getting teaching. Mm-hmm. You gotta go beyond just being motivated. Glory to God. And impacted. Just remember the prophetic. Almost anything you hear in a prophetic church, you must have a prophetic perspective. Are you there? Mm-hmm. Listen, Lord. If you're listening well, you know, for many years, I called Florida the sea. You're sitting in the sea. I don't care who like me. No matter where you're going, Florida, it's the sand. You know what is it? The sand. Come on, don't come to the one thing. It's in the sea you live. Come on. It's the waters you live. See, I don't understand the woman of God. She don't even understand how to preach it. Because she can't handle it. Is the prophetic providence of God. She's handling right there in the pulpit. Hey! What do you believe in the waters? It's water you live in. But God knows why he sent you there. Hallelujah. Because you split it.
And then they're going to try to follow you. And you're going to take them. You're not with me, somebody. Yeah. Glory to God. God got to send you to the waters. Or to the waters. To see who is his. You there? Come on, somebody. That's where we are right now. Don't be afraid of the waters. The second thing, if you have been saved for a while and you're not getting baptized, get baptized. Come on, you don't want me to give explanation. Anybody, and you're watching, you may be in town and some of you getting saved. Come on, get baptized. Did you know that in New York, almost every third person, especially brown, you walk, every third person you see and you talk to them, they say, I got baptized and I was coming. Yeah. They may be going to a different church, but that's all right. Glory to God. So you need the water is the sign, is the public sign. The water is the public marriage. I mean, we could go into the depths of it biologically and all of that, but the water is the public sign that you are God's. The water is the testing point of your commitment. The waters is the point of the marriage to Christ. You know what one of God explained about the bride of Christ? Did it open your eyes more? How a husband treat a bride, or a bridegroom treat a bride. And if you understand that, you can prophesy. Hallelujah. And you know what can happen and what will happen. For no good husband leave his wife.
That's right.
I told a guy was driving this week and he was kind of talking and he said, you know, if there's an accident, I know how to shield myself. I said, no, I don't mean bad. I said, you must die for your wife. She must, you must take the hit on your side so she be saved. I am not a real husband yet. You know, people don't want, you don't want explanation. Are you with me? That's how Jesus is. Don't worry. My husband's not like that. But that's how Jesus is.
Yes.
He take the hit, give his life for his bride. So his bride must come. So if you want the bride, come get married. Glory to God. Come. That's what I'm preaching tonight. It's water. It's the water. Come on. You are his bride. You're so special. Come get married. And those of you watching will give your heart to the Lord. Some of you are wrong, Central Florida. Go to any harvest army and get married. Get baptized. Come on, somebody. And tonight I ask you, the water was in there for it. I will be blamed, come on. Glory to God. But if after church over, and you want baptized, we don't fill it up for you. We don't fill it up for you. I thought you'd be all clapping. What's wrong with you? Are you jealous of the bride? My God, Glory to God. Then she continued to preach about the waters. The waters also represent judgment. Right. Because you can go, you can split it, but they can't split it.
Noah's flood. Noah's flood.
Yeah. Lord God. And finally, the city will be a water city. But we can't explain everything about that. The city. My God, we'll be water city. Everybody can come in here if they want. Everybody can go to heaven. It will be a water city. Never heard about no water city in my life. Get ready for it. That's why I sent to Florida already. Did you know that there are some ministers even today call and say something is upon me? Something is upon me. Don't be surprised if I show up. Church pastor! Say, let it happen. We don't know everything, but let it happen.
That's right.
Let it move. somebody. You ain't saying amen. No, I got to not say amen anymore. Let the move move. Those who came from Georgia, do must go back. You want me to be normal. You want me to suit you. You don't want my power. You just want to be normal. You don't want to go back. You don't want to believe me. You may leave Bishop here now and I go to, and I go to. You may leave Bishop with family and say, you stay here and I go to Georgia. You're not ready for stuff. And as soon as a revival, the man preach one night. Some Souza, Pensacola revival. Right in the Florida Panhandle. Pensacola revival. The man preaches Sunday night. I'm gonna let you go. When he was finished, the pastor come to him and say, as of tonight, you are the pastor. You don't want to hear nothing. Come on, somebody. And he became the pastor for 3.5 years, nearly 5 years of revival. Millions of people from across the globe could not help but be there. You have to be ready. The water is troubled. Shiva! Somebody said the water is troubled. Somebody said the water is troubled. Somebody said we are ready to split the waters. Shiva, ba, ba, ba.
Bishop Katie Collins, General Overseer of Harvest Army Church. You may not understand everything he was saying, but I hope you got a grasp of it. What he was saying is that we need prophecy in the church to live. And when God troubles the waters, healing's available. Healing's available. And that healing comes with salvation also, and salvation comes with healing also, and you can't separate the difference. Amen, somebody. Praise God. Hallelujah. Give your hands to the Lord. Amen. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise for what he's doing these last days. Amen. Hallelujah. Revival Fireside. And now I believe our children's ministry has something she wants to share also. Put your hands together for little Jeslyn. Amen. Children ministry. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Bless you, Jesus. Bless your holy name.
Okay. I put it wrong.
It's okay. Take your time. It's okay.
He asked them for advice in the matters that required wisdom and understanding. The king always found their answers to be best. Other men in this kingdom. He claimed to get knowledge by using magic. Daniel studied for 3 years. He worked hard to learn everything he could. Then he served the king. Daniel did a great job. King God guided Daniel as he helped the king. God gave Daniel wisdom. Daniel could answer the king's questions better than the king's own people. The king was impressed with Daniel. God blessed Daniel with a special wisdom. Help me to use my knowledge to give you glory, God.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Give the Lord a hand clap. Amen. Now, I believe there's something else she also wants to share. Now, keep in mind, she's 8 years old. Right? You're not 7. You're not 9. You're 8. Amen. So, she's 8 years old and God's dealing with her in a very special way. How many know Daniel was young when God began to deal with Daniel, Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego? And I did not tell her that. I did not teach her that. You got to understand. Amen. She wants to share something that God has revealed to her. Amen.
Okay. In this little place, there was spring. The trees were growing up good. They were growing into summer. Summer gave them fruit. And then there was fall and winter. Fall and winter were bad, and summer and spring were good. And I had another one, and it was about summer and spring trees were getting chopped down by a man, and the fall and winter were not giving any plants to the little trees that made them die. And then, because the trees in fall and winter didn't have no leaves, all the men died. Only the ones that chopped down the trees. It was like God was only saying that the ones that do bad will. And they had to get a punishment.
Amen. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Amen. She saw this in a vision, brothers and sisters. She had always dreamed dreams, and now she's starting to see visions of seasons and times that God is dealing with his church. And that bad is coming and famines are coming because people choose to cut down good trees. What is this church made of? Wood. Good tree. The cross and the blood of Jesus. Jesus said, daughters of Zion, do not weep for me, but weep for your children, because the time come, if they do this to a good tree that is green, what will they do in the dry season, when I'm gone, my spirit is gone, my truth is gone, my sacrifice has been fulfilled. What will they do then to my church and my people? Do not weep for me. Weep for them. Weep for your children. Amen. The Bible says, be instant in season, out of season. Preach the word, does it not? And so many want to come against the preaching of the word and the blood of Jesus and the preachers of righteousness and all else. Amen. Am I telling the truth? These are the last days. Perilous times shall come. The Bible says in Matthew 24, it says that there will be famines and pestilence and earthquakes in diverse places. Is that what the word says? Amen. That Jesus, we know, prophesied of the dream and vision that she gave to a little 8-year-old girl. Amen. Praise the Lord forevermore. He's pouring out his spirit these last days. Let's pray. Over you? Has there ever been a time that you maybe should have died, or maybe you did die and he brought you back? Brother Mike, is it okay if I address you and speak to you, if the Lord prophesied to you? Amen. Could you come up forward real quick here? Amen. First of all, I want to say I love you, brother. Good to see you. Amen. when I went to visit you at the hospital in Charlotte, I felt the prayers of every saint of God that prayed for your situation. And God kept you here for a reason and a purpose, because he loves you. He loves you. He died for you. And there's a reason why you're still here breathing. Amen. And I'm still here breathing when we should have been dead. God said, no, not today, devil. Amen. He kept you when the doctors thought, hallelujah, that it was over. And some people started doubting and said, it's over. He's in a bad state. He's in a bad condition. I walked in and I just knew that the Lord was going to bring you out of the situation that he brought you out of. And the reason why you're still breathing to this very day is the hand of God is with you and over you. Do you feel that? Amen. Do you know that? Do you know he loves you? Father,
well, I thank you for keeping my brother. I thank you for your power. I thank you for your hand of protection always prevailing. I thank you for the safety net that surrounds him and the family. Glory be to the Lamb of God. Thank you for your love and your grace and your mercy. Even when we don't deserve it, you're still there, God. Thank you for bringing them here this day for a reason and a time such as this. Your mighty right hand, Lord, with your blessing, help them, heal them, and keep them as you have in times past. I pray for his soul and safety, prosperity, and love and healing. For it's in Jesus' name I love him, as you love him also. Amen.
Amen. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's continue to worship the Lord.
More than I can say, I imagine your peace.
I'm melting your peace.
They're not alone if you got God, but you got to have God. Amen. Somebody, it might feel like you're alone, but even if you can't see him, he's working. Even if you can't feel him, he's working. He never stops. He never stops. He never stops working. Emmanuel, God with us. Amen. Praise the living God. Amen. If you have your Bibles, will you please turn with me? By the way, before we open, this is a house of prayer and praise. Amen. Are there unspoken prayer requests by the lifting of hands? Amen. We've heard some requests also spoken. Bring your burden to the Lord and leave it there. We're going to have an altar call at the end of service. Pray through. Press through. You are not alone. Amen. Go ahead, sister.
I felt him touch me a while ago.
Yeah, he touched me too.
I know.
Oh, yes. Hallelujah.
I got to walk this battle by myself.
That's it.
He's with me.
Come on.
Every jump of the way, he's not going to let me down.
That's right. That's right. You've got it. You've got it.
I got to go to Chapel Hill Tuesday. He's going to be with me there.
You're not alone. And
like I told my brother, you have nothing to worry about.
Hallelujah.
You're not alone.
You're not alone. Praise the living God.
I said, you're going to come out and you're going to be fine.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Brothers and sisters, watching, pray for us. Stretch forth your hand this way. We know we're not alone, but we got an army too, brothers and sisters. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I ask for a good report through and through, by and by. Lord, you're no respecter of persons. What you did for me, you could do for her. Oh, Father God, all throughout her family, I declare and claim and I plead the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah, for a good report and a turnaround. Press through, Lord, break it. Let them know that they are not alone. Lord, if there need be salvation, Lord, let it be. If there need be healing, Lord, let it be. Lord, we touch and agree today in the mighty name of Jesus. There's nothing like the name of Jesus. There's nobody like the name of Jesus. There's nothing above the name of Jesus. You are the name above every name and the name above everything. In the maximum name of Jesus, out of the love of God, I pray for my sister, everybody watching and listening, and everybody here in the building, and those that will watch later. In Jesus' name, I plead the blood. I rebuke the devil. If there will be healing, there will be miracles. If there will be performance of the power of God in their life, to those listening, watching, and receiving this prayer right now, by faith, we touch and agree and believe in the power and the blood of Jesus. And let the church say together, amen and amen. Hallelujah. Bless you all so much and mightily in the Lord, in the maximum name of Jesus. If you have your Bibles, will you please turn with me into the preaching hour? Amen. St. Mark, hallelujah, the 10th chapter, beginning at verse 40, dealing with the life of blind Bartimaeus. Amen. If you need a Bible, they're all around. Amen. There's one here also. Amen. Praise the Lord. God is good. He's faithful. Bless your kind gesture to your neighbors. Amen. This is talking about a reward to service. Are we in service right now for the Lord? Are you on the battlefield for the Lord? Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I promised him that I would serve him till I die. I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Hallelujah. Verse 40, chapter 10. It says, but to sit on my right hand and on my left hand is not mine to give, but it shall be given to them for whom it is prepared. And when the 10 heard it, they began to be much displeased with James and John. But Jesus called to them and said unto them, ye know that they which are accounted to rule over the Gentiles exercise lordship over them, and their great ones exercise authority upon them. But so shall it not be among you, but whosoever will be great among you shall be your minister, and whosoever of you will be the chiefest shall be a servant of all. Amen. For even the Son of Man came not to be ministered unto, but to minister and to give his life for a ransom for many. And they came unto Jericho, and as he went out of Jericho with his disciples, a great number of people, blind Bartimaeus, the son of Timaeus, sat by the highway side of it. And when he heard it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out and say, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. And many charged him that he should hold his peace, but he cried the more a great deal, thou son of David, have mercy on me. And Jesus stood still and commanded him to be called. And they called the blind man, saying unto him, be of good comfort, rise, he calleth thee. And he, casting away his garment, rose and came to Jesus. He came to Jesus. And Jesus answered and said unto him, what wilt thou that I should do unto thee? And the blind man said unto him, Lord, that I might receive my sight. And Jesus said unto him, go thy way, thy faith made thee whole. And immediately he received his sight and followed Jesus in the way. You may be seated. Most gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, we ask for that KO power, that miraculous, wandering, healing power, the power of the blood of the Lamb be available. Rise up today, O Holy Ghost, thy Son of David, have mercy on us. As we cry to the Most High God, Lord, we look for a move of power and authority that is only found in your way and your anointing. Lord, I ask for blessings. I ask for salvation. I ask that the blind may see. I ask that the dead be raised. I ask that the lepers be cleansed. And we will give you the praise. For you are the way, the truth, and the life. And no man can come unto the Father except by you through the door, the open door. Behold, the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world. I thank you and praise you, Lord, for your love, your grace, your mercy, your healing, miraculous, wonderful power. In the maximum name of Jesus, I pray. And I give this service and these scriptures to you. Let them come alive, Lord. We look for a move of the Holy Ghost for us in Jesus' name. I thank you. I praise you and I love you. Amen and amen. The first thing we ought to know is that there is a reward waiting for you. If you are in the Lord, if you are called to the Lord, there is a reward waiting for you if you're on the battlefield. You're called to service in the army of God. You're called to tell somebody about Jesus. I'm just a nobody trying to tell everybody about somebody that saved my soul. Can I get an amen in the house of God? Hallelujah. The promises are given to his church and the humble. The Bible says God resists the proud and the cocky and the boastful and give grace to the nobodies and the humble. The Bible says if you humble yourself in sight of God, he will lift you up. We need that uplifting today. We need that strength today. We need that blessing and favor today. We need the name of Jesus today. Can I get an amen? Hallelujah. There is a divine preparation in store for you and your family and the service here today. Does that make sense to anybody? There is a divine presence and power that is available to us, the children of God and the people of God. If you don't know God, it is a divine appointment that you come to know God and that you be born again. The Bible says ye must be born again. Born of the water and born of the Spirit. Amen. Born of the blood and born of the water that poured out of his hallelujah heart and sacrifice on the cross. So divine preparation, promises to the humble, and blessings in the service in the army of God. Anybody following me this morning, this afternoon? Amen. This also speaks of men's jealousy. Has anybody ever been jealous of you? For whatever reason, has anybody ever been jealous of little old you? I don't got nothing. I'm a nobody. Why are you jealous of me for? Amen. But the Bible says God is no respecter of persons. Why when I go get a red apple, yay big, you got to go get a red apple, yay big too? Why can't you get a banana? Jealousy. Done away with in Jesus' name. Amen, somebody. Amen. Hallelujah. new principles to the kingdom of God in the New Testament. God says that he would do a new thing in the last days, didn't he? He said he would pour out his spirit, didn't he? Can you feel his touch? Can you feel his power? Can you feel his presence? He keeps his promises, don't he? Amen, hallelujah. The Bible also declares unto us, hallelujah, that, hallelujah, it is a new testament. It is a new promise. It is a new covenant. It is a new thing. And it is a new blessing that has never been done before. In the olden times, in the Old Testament, God would move upon ministers and move upon people of God only for a certain time. But can I tell you, you can have that all the time? Hallelujah, that's a new thing. You ought to praise God. Amen. Somebody want to give him some praise. Hallelujah, it's a new thing. Amen. You can feel him anywhere at any time. Oh, hallelujah. He holds utmost supreme authority. Aren't you thankful for that? Amen. Hallelujah. It tells you, hallelujah, that you can regain what you have lost, giving sight to the blind. When you could not see, now you see. When you could not hear, now you hear. When you could not understand, now you understand. Is anybody following me in the house of God? When you had a scratchy voice, when you used to sing, now you're anointed and you can sing a little bit. Amen. You used to couldn't preach. You don't even know what preaching is. You can't preach without the Holy Ghost. But when he moves upon you, you can't help but preach. Amen. Is anybody following me? Amen. In the house of God, there's a fire that is burning. There's a blessing that is available. And I don't even know what to call this service. I don't even know what to title this message other than Jesus heals. I said Jesus heals and Jesus is real. Amen. Hallelujah. Somebody ought to praise the Lord. Somebody ought to bless the Lord. Somebody ought to thank the Lord. He's real. He's real. Oh, yes, heal way down in my soul. Ever since he rescued me, he gave my heart a song to sing. I want to tell the whole world about Jesus. Hallelujah. The zeal of thine house burned me up. We preached that this morning about there's no other ordination or anointing by which heaven has given, no other name, no other authority. Amen. So service is enjoying. When you come to the presence of God, God comes into your presence, doesn't he? Amen. When you come to the house of God, God will meet you here, won't he? Amen. Hallelujah. So you join in to something that is already predestined and a divine preparation. Hallelujah. To a service that is by a divine God. He knew that you would be here. He knew that you would be sitting here. He knew that I would be preaching this message to you today. He knows everything. And you were not alone. You're not alone. You're not alone. This speaks of Christ with a servant heart. This speaks of the Son of Man. This speaks of the Son of God. This speaks of the Lord Jesus Christ. All power and authority is given unto him, isn't it? Amen. When he was crucified, dead, and buried, the third day he arose from the dead. The Bible says he conquered death, hell, and the grave. That means cancer. That means C-19. That means when you ought to die, you're going to live anyway. He conquered it all. He's over all. All authority and power is given to him. Even if you got a little rash on your arm, he's over there too, Mama. Oh, yes. You got a little hurt in your belly. He's over there too, glory to God. You got some bad news from the doctor. He's over there too, amen. You got a big, fat light bill. He's over there too. Give him some praise in the house of God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It speaks of searching for a Savior. Searching for a healer. When death ought to happen, being me or ours, his death happened in our place. When it should have been me that was dumb, deaf, and blind, he took responsibility upon himself and carried the cross for you. What a mighty God. What a mighty God. I feel him in this place. I feel his presence and power. It says that, hallelujah, they went into Jericho, hallelujah, and the apostles with multitude were moved. behalf of Jesus and move with Jesus, but sometimes the apostles would get in the way of the work of God. I said sometimes people of God get in the way of the work of God. The walls of Jericho did what? Fell down. They came tumbling down. And the walls of blind Bartimaeus did what? Same thing. At the same place, in the same area, by the same God. And he could do the same thing for you. But there is a happiness to holiness, and there is a holiness to healing, and there's a healing in happiness, and there's a happiness in healing, and you can't separate or cut it or slice it any different than that is presented. Amen. Preacher, what you're saying to me? I'm saying the Bible says, be ye holy, for I am holy, says God. I'm telling you, amen, if you want to see the blind healed today, amen, if you want to lay hands on the sick and they recover, you've got to live holy. You've got to live happy. You got to live healthy, and you got to live and walk by faith, not by sight. Is anybody following me? Amen. The apostles knew all well as the multitude was moving that, hallelujah, the blind man and the beggar, hallelujah, needed some help. Amen. And oftentimes, hallelujah, can I tell you, hallelujah, as a servant of God and a preacher of God, a disciple of God, a pastor and teacher and evangelist of God, sometimes, hallelujah, I need help too, just as a beggar would beg, hallelujah. I'm begging for people to come to the altar to be saved. I'm begging, hallelujah, for somebody to get healed in Jesus' name. I'm rooting for Jesus Christ, hallelujah. I'm rooting that this house of God be filled and that people be burned up by the zeal of Almighty God. I'm begging that souls be saved and people be healed. Hallelujah. Cleanse the lepers. Oh, heal the sick and raise the dead. Oh, I'm begging too in Jesus' name. I beg and beseech, cry out, pray and fast, weep, and plead the blood and bind and loose. Do it some more. Hallelujah. Jesus of Nazareth had came nigh. Is he in the place? Blind Bartimaeus went crying to the only one who knew that could heal him. He knew that the Lord could heal him. Jesus, thy son of David, have mercy on me. Was ever a prayer pray? It's the most mightiest prayer ever prayed, other than the Lord Jesus saying, Father, not my will, but thy will be done. The greatest prayer a believer can pray by faith is, Jesus, have mercy on me. The greatest prayer other than that is, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Another great prayer to pray, hallelujah, is not my will be done in all my selfishness and pride and boasting, but thy will be done, O Lord. Hallelujah. It's sickening in Christianity today, in churches today, or churches in Christianity, so-called, how selfish people are. Instead of worrying about the neighbor or seeing blind Bartimaeus and wanting to help, I'm out for self. Look at me. Look at what I just did. Look at me. Take a good look, you see. It ain't about you. It's about the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen, somebody. Hallelujah, that he heals. Hallelujah, that he's real. That he saves. Amen, that he builds the church. He gives vans. minds. Amen. He puts up our playgrounds. He provides. He's Jehovah Rapha, and he will provide. He'll provide a ram caught in the thicket on Mount Moriah. Can I get an amen? How selfish we become as Christians to say it's all about me. Look at me. Look at all I've done. Make a TikTok about everything. Me. Look at me. Weren't you singing a song? You should be saying, Jesus, the Son of David, have mercy on me. That's what we ought to be saying. Am I preaching it right?
The blind man, I cannot see. Oh, Son of David, have mercy on me. Then Jesus spoke so sweet and low. Arise, my child, thy faith has made thee whole. If Jesus said it, I believe it. His word cannot lie. If it's written in the Bible, I believe it till I die. Though the mountains be removed and fastened to the sea, God's word will last forever
throughout eternity.
In my father's house, there's plenty of room. I'm coming soon to set to place my waiting bride and take her home over on the other side. If Jesus said it, I believe it. If word cannot lie, if it's written in the Bible, I believe it till I die. Oh, nothing's been removed.
Our word will last forever throughout eternity. Glory! I say glory! Hallelujah! We call that a praise break. If you didn't know, now you know. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you for chiming in, Mother. Let God use you. Amen. Let God use you. In the Spirit of God, I would never stop somebody who's in the Spirit of God. In flesh, I'm going to shut that down. Me. Look at me. No. Let's look at him. Throughout eternity. Is anybody having some fun today? Hallelujah. Thank God for that, the blessing. Hallelujah. Crying unto Jesus, mercy sought, mercy needed. I need a Savior. I don't know about you. I'm pretty sure you do, because the Bible says that all have fallen short of the glory of God. But I know that I need a Savior. And I know there's only one. There's 4,200 religions and some change. There's only one stone that's rolled away. And there's only one bloody cross, old Roman cross, that God died for his people, that God sent his only son. There's only one. You ask me how I know that I have the truth. Oh, buddy, I could tell you some things. I know I have the truth. I know that 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 I know. My name is written there. Like a tree planted by the waters, I shall not be moved. Anybody else feel that? Anybody else know that? Anybody else appreciate that? Amen. God is good. Praise God. The heartlessness of the world can come into the church. The heartlessness of what we fight off can creep into the church. I heard another preacher say it like this recently. He said, I am dead. The old me has passed away, and I know it. But sometimes I can hear him scratching and clawing out of that old casket trying to get up out of the grave. But I'm here to tell you, you better keep him down. You better kick him down. Because I have to decrease so that he can increase in me. It's the only way to be able to preach accurately, preach boldly, preach anointed, is if I go away and hide behind the cross and he appear. It's the only way. It's the only way it should be. But the heartlessness of people, selfishness of people, the pride of people, God ain't in it. He ain't in it. But what he is in is when you say mercy, Lord. When you cry, he collects your tears. Tears move him. In need, when you're in need, he's there. You're never alone. Praise the Lord. Sometimes we got to hold our peace. We want to say something, you know, smack the devil in the back of the head. Sometimes we just got to hold our peace. Amen. The dismissal right away of the needy. Guess what? That's what the church is for. The church is for the needy, and I'm one of the needy. The God called the whosoever, and I'm a whosoever. God did not come to save the righteous. He did not come to heal the ones that did not need healing. He came to save that which was lost, and he came to heal the sick. The righteous man need not a physician. But I was not righteous. I needed the great physician, the doctor of all, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Does anybody else feel like that? I heard a preacher say recently, I am the least of all preachers. And he didn't clarify as to why. But if he's anything like I am, and he feels like I do, I knew exactly what he was saying. I'm the least of all preachers worldwide. I'm the least. I'm not the greatest. At the very most, I'm somewhere in between. But I'm the least. Because God has called me from way low, 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 up out of the ground. You see, I was dead. I was buried. I was nothing. I was nobody. I was trash in the garbage. But you know what Jesus did? With that old broken vessel, he took lamb's blood. Check me out on this. He took lamb's blood and used it as glue. And he fixed my broken vessel. And now I can hold water. Check me out on that. You can use lamb's blood for glue. Amen. Hallelujah. What does blood do when it dries? When it dries, it gets hard, right? You can stick something together. Sometimes it gets sticky. He used his blood, the Lamb of God, to fix my broken vessel. Does anybody else feel like that? This is an importunity, if you will, or an opportunity for a great move of God to not forsake people that are in need or people that are sick or people that are lost or people who are out in the world. Don't act like you're better than nobody because you ain't. You are not better than anybody. God called us and cleaned us up, and God is no respecter of persons. So what God is saying right there is this. If you're born again, go get some more to be born again. Amen. Some that were just like you. Tell your testimony to somebody. Amen. It's just like you. That's the reason why he sends us out. Amen. The Bible says that we're sent out as sheep for the slaughter among wolves. Amen. They will cut you up. They will carve you up. They will want to use you as hamburger meat. But I'm here to tell you that God is greater and God will be with you. I want to encourage somebody today, amen, in the house of God. You are not alone. I said you're not alone. Hallelujah. Bringing men to Jesus, he said, follow after me and I will make you, what? Fishers of men. But we have to have the right bait. We have to have the bait of love. We can't be going around acting jealous. We can't go acting selfish. We can't go in no other name other than the name of Jesus and love. If we go in the name of jealousy, jealousy is what we will reap. If we go in the name of selfishness, selfishness is what we will reap. You will reap what you sow. And your ministry will be as such. Whatever seed you lay down, that will be your harvest. Can I get an amen? Fault-finding ministry. Well, that's what you're going to reap. Better than you ministry. Well, that's what you're going to reap. Hateful holiness. Well, that's what you're going to reap. Love. That's what you're going to reap. Hallelujah. Encouragement and exhortation, leaving it all up to Jesus, is the right way. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no man come to the Father except by me. We got to have great faith. If we just ask, we will receive. Seek him, we will find. Amen. So he sought after Jesus and he found Jesus. He sought after a healing and he got a healing. Even more than a healing, he got a miracle. Restoring sight to the blind. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. Saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found. I was blind, but now I see. You got it. You got it. Gotta have great faith telling people about Jesus. Your faith will be honored. Did you hear what I said? Your faith in Jesus Christ will be honored. He will honor you. As you honor him, you reap what you sow. You sow what you reap. Coming to a close now. Christ heals all of his followers. Somebody say all. Christ heals all of his followers. Somebody say all. Louder. Christ heals all of his followers. Somebody say all. Hallelujah. He heals us. Those that follow after him. He raises us up for specific tasks and purposes. Specific gifts. No. No two are alike. No. All are different. You can't put me in the same category as Billy Graham, or Billy Graham in the same category as Jimmy Swagger, or Jimmy Swagger in the same category as, name somebody, I don't care. You can't do it. We're all different. No two are alike. Elijah and Paul, John and Jesus, and Peter and James, and all of them, Martha, Mary, no two are alike. Hallelujah. Christ came to save that which is lost. Turn with me now, one more scripture, to Luke 7 and 21. And I need the operator to come up here and get ready, please. Luke 7, 21. Thank you so much for your faithfulness. Hanging in there. Hallelujah. Luke the physician likened unto Jesus. The apostle Luke records in 7th chapter verse 21. It says, and in the same hour he cured many of their infirmities and plagues and of evil spirits, and unto many that were blind he gave sight. Can I get an amen? Christ heals. He's our burden bearer, and devils are cast out. If you have an infirmity, you need to understand we wrestle not against flesh and blood. You need to understand that Jesus is above that devil. You need to understand it is a demonic attack. Cancer does not come from God. It's not a blessing or favor from God. It is a demonic spirit, and we have to take authority over it in Jesus' name. And he's a healer. Amen? So if you need to come and stand in the gap for any brother or sister, or you need a healing yourself, or you need salvation, here's your time. Is there set the time? Today is the day of salvation. Would you come? Would you come to be prayed for? Would you come to make your request known unto God? Whoever you are, wherever you are, Pray to the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. He will meet your needs according to his riches in Christ Jesus in glory. Cry out. Amen. Hallelujah. If you need salvation, he's got it. If you need healing, he's got it. If you need a miracle, he's waiting on you. You ain't waiting on him. Hallelujah. I plead the blood of Jesus. Let him draw you. Let him call you. Let him heal you. Let him touch you. Let him bless you. Hallelujah.
He made the mountains and the seas. He's in control of everything.
Hallelujah, Lord Jesus.
And he knows my name. Every step that I take.
Lord, I plead the blood of Jesus. Over every believer at the altar right now. Every believer at the altar of their heart. You're there, Lord, to meet the needs, Lord. We look for a good report. We praise you. We worship you, O God. King of kings and Lord of lords. You're able, Lord. You have ultimate authority today. We bind those devils. We ask that you cast them out loose, O Lord. We praise you, O God, for what you're doing, what you've done, what you're about to do. There's nothing too hard for you, O God. You are Jehovah Rapha. Jehovah Shalom, our peace. We have the victory in you, O God. Conquerors through Christ Jesus. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. You're the same God that healed blind Bartimaeus, and you can heal us too. You can heal our broken hearts and spirits, our broken churches, our broken nations and leaders, our broken hearts of pastors, lost souls. You can heal it all and do it all, Lord. We ask you, God, for a move in these last days to heal cancer, C19, and bone problems, and joint problems, and organ problems, and muscle problems, and jaw problems. Hallelujah. Whatever it is, God, you've got it. Thank you, Master. Thank you, Savior. Thank you for the cross. Thank you for the blood and the power. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Good reports, good news. Mighty right hand of God. Jesus Christ of Nazareth, have mercy on us, God. As we wail, as we wail, as we wail between the porch and the altar, we wail, we cry out, Abba Father, help us, Holy Ghost. Bless us now, God. Hallelujah. Let there be a move of God. Let there be a revival in the last days. Pour it out, God. Thank you for Brother Jesse watching over his mama. Thank you for mama. Thank you for church mother. Hallelujah. Thank you for piano playing. Faithful piano playing. Oh, move upon them, Lord. Move on the scene, Lord. Pour it out on YouTube. Pour it out on TikTok. Baptize us in the Holy Ghost and fire. Thank you, Father. Bless this church. Bless these preachers. Bless these people on the rise for God. Oh, save the lost. Save our family, God. Heal our families, God. Heal our communities, God. Heal our schools, God. Do it, Lord. Do it, Lord. Do it, Lord. I know that you can. I know you're ready, willing, and able. Move on the scene. We cry out, Abba Father, in the mighty matchless name of Jesus, in the maximum name of Jesus, in the unmatchable name of Jesus. Oh, that's how I glory. Glory be to the Lamb of God. Oh, hallelujah, Holy Ghost. Help us, Father. In the name of Jesus, He knows your name and you are not alone today.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Amen. Don't stop the songs. Don't stop service. Amen. Your people come. Hallelujah. Go ahead and play. praising him. He's worthy to be praised.
He knows how much sand is on the shores. He sees every sparrow that falls. He made the mountains and the seas. He's in control of everything, of all creatures great and small. And he knows my name, every step that I take, every move that I make, every tear that I cry. He knows my name, but I'm overwhelmed by the pain. Can't see the light of day. I know I'll be just fine, 'cause he knows my name. I don't know what tomorrow will bring. I can't tell you in store. I don't know a lot of things. I don't have all the answers to the questions of life, but I know in my head and he knows my name, every step that I take, every move that I, every tear that I cry. He knows my name, and I'm overwhelmed by the pain. Can't see the light of day. I know I'll be just fine.
If nobody wants to go, preacher's face, which came down the aisle. He went running and shouting all over the place, and you could hear it for a country mile. There was a rowdy old creek that wasn't very deep, that ran behind the tents. When she came up shouting, I got to say, that's where everybody went. The muddy water calls a preacher's daughter just got saved. She's a daughter stands through an old time altar with a good Lord took them all away. I bet he never ever thought that the one God called would be the same one that he raised. Come down to the muddy water calls a preacher's daughter got saved. Come down. Preacher's daughter just got saved. She took all her sins to an all-time altar where the good Lord took them all away. I bet he never ever thought that the one God called would be the same one that he raised. Come down to the muddy water where the preacher's daughter got saved. I bet he never ever thought that the one God called would be the same one that he raised. Amen. If you've enjoyed your service and today, give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Amen. Somebody ought to praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. We're going to dismiss and we're going to call it good and we're going to call it done and we're going to call it God. Amen. God did it. He did it again. Amen. One more under the belt in Jesus' name. We did it again, church. We did it. Amen. He said, wherever two or three are gathered in his name, he's in the middle of us, in the midst. And I felt that fire burning all day. I felt his presence. I felt his praises go up. I felt the blessings fall down. Amen. He healed blind Bartimaeus, and he can heal us too. Amen. Praise God. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we close out today's service. We just thank you for your counsel and meeting us here. We love you and appreciate your holiness and your healing and your happiness and your health and your wealth and all you have in heaven. Oh, that's a lot of H's. But we thank you most of all for the name of Jesus. We thank you most of all for the name of Yeshua. We thank you, Abba Father, oh Elohim, El Shaddai, Emmanuel, God with us. We praise you for who you are. Now go with us, Lord, throughout the remainder of this day. And throughout all the week, amen, and gather back with us again when we meet next time. We want to meet you here one more time, for it's in Jesus' name we know we're not alone, and I pray for these that you have given us, in Jesus' name, amen. You're the good shepherd. Go with them and bless them in Jesus' name, and let the church say, amen, amen, and amen. Amen. Go in peace. Tell somebody about Jesus out in here and tell somebody about Jesus out there. Play the song, operator. Amen.
God be with you till we meet again. By his counsels, I uphold you. With his sheep securely fold you. God be with you till we meet again. Till we meet. Jesus, till we meet, God be with you till we meet again. God be with you till we meet again. When my sparrows thick and found you, put his loving arms around you. God be with you till we meet again. Till we meet, till we meet, till we meet at Jesus' feet. Till we meet, till we meet, God be with you till we meet again.
Amen. Amen. Sister Sylvia wanted to share something real quick before we go. While she's coming up here, the Lord's revealing a temptation of two men, one who is without a family and one who has a family. And the Lord is revealing that the temptation is as of Sodom and Gomorrah. And the Lord says you can overcome. You rely on him. Be careful. Be cautious. The devil is out there. He's like a roaring lion seeking who he may devour. Amen. Don't let no strange thing overtake you in the trial that you're in. God bless you.
I just want to say that if you're running from the Lord, don't do it. Just go ahead and give in, because he will see you through. Mm-hmm. He will walk with you all the way. He said, I'm going to let you down.
Come on.
Praise for Jesus. I've been baptized.
Praise God.
And I appreciate that.
Thank God for it.
I'm saved.
Hallelujah.
I appreciate that.
Oh, yeah.
Because now I know the Lord is with me and he's not going to let me down. So Tuesday, when I go to Chapel Hill, I'm going to pray for my brother and the ones that's going to be there with us, the family, the doctors, the nurses, everything, to make sure that he knows that the Lord's with him. Because he told me the other day, he said, Sister, he said, for the first time in a long, long time, I put my papers in this Bible, and I prayed over it. He said, and I felt something. I said, brother, I said, don't give up. Don't give up. Whatever you do, don't give up. Just keep pushing. The Lord's with you. Keep pushing. He said that one of his neighbors had come over and prayed with him. I said, well, that's good. I'm glad that they did. But I've been there about every other day with him, trying to keep his mind off of things and everything. But, you know, it's kind of hard when you got a family. And you don't see. I'm going to tell you, you're running from the Lord. You need to just go ahead, let it out, give it in, and receive him. Because I'm telling you, it will change your life. It will change your life forever. You will be able to walk up to people and pray for them. There's people out there that's lost. There's people out there that's homeless. But all we can do is pray for him. Let him know that Jesus loves him.
That's right. Praise Jesus. Thank you, Father.
All I'm going to say, if you're lost, Wednesday night would be the time to come up to the altar and get saved.
Yes.
You will be a whole different person.
Oh, yes.
I promise you. A whole different person. And you will feel different than what you do now.
That's right. That's right.
And you may sit there and say, Sister, how do you know that? because I just got it right here tonight. I'm saved. I love it. I'm walking with the Lord now,
yes,
for sure.
Yes,
and He's got my hand, and He's not going to let me go.
Hallelujah.
So Tuesday, I know when I pray for my brother, the nurses, the doctors, the anesthesiologists, that's going to be in there with him. I know when they come out, they're not going to look at me and say, oh, I think I got it all. They're going to look at me and say, we got it all.
Jesus.
He'll be okay.
In the name of-
and in 4 days, he gets to go home.
Ooh.
I don't know if he's going to have special care or not. We won't know until Tuesday. But I'm just telling you, if you're running from the Lord, just give it in. Just come up here to the altar. And if you don't want to kneel down, there's the pastor. Ask him. Tell him, say, I'm lost. I need help. Can you save me? Or can you help me get saved?
I point you to the
and
yes. Yes.
He can put that anointing oil on you. And I'm telling you, when he does, you're going to feel fire all the way down to your feet. That's what I've been telling you. I'm alone. You got the devil on your back, and you need him off. You don't need the devil. You need the Lord up above. Because there's things that we're going through right now. It's not just one in our family that's got cancer. It's two or three.
Boy, you gotta realize love all the hate towards me by the family.
It doesn't matter. The Lord can change everything. I'm telling you, the Lord can change everything. You need to get the devil off of your back.
You can do it. You can do it for your brother, Jesus. The love of God. The love of God.
Yeah.
You came a long way since I first met you. And we all got a long way.
And he has. And he takes care of me. He makes sure that, you know, when I have seizures, he knows what to do. But that's not the point. The point is, what I'm trying to get over to him is he needs to receive it instead of running from it. I was running from it for a while, and then one day I just got off at that puke, and I come up here, and it was over. It was really over. I give it all to him. And that's all you got to do. Just give it to him. And leave it there. Don't take it back.
That's right. Amen.
Thank
hallelujah.
You.
Bless you, sister. Bless you. Bless you. Hallelujah. Thank God for you and your testimony. I'm glad you felt the fire from the top of the head to the soles of the feet. Amen. That's the Bible. Amen. That's what we want. We want revival. Bless you and your family so much. Amen. Brother Jesse, it's not that you're a lost soul. It's just that the devil fights us, brother. Amen. If you just submit and receive, like your mama said, you will see the greatest power you've ever felt in your life. Praise God. Hallelujah. He fights us all.
I can tell you the reason why I got like this.
Well, we understand past, but we're talking about now and future.
I don't mean like that. I'm talking about like my attitude and the way I see the life towards people today. Basically, all that changed whenever I lost my father.
I understand. I lost my dad too at a young
basically,
age.
Basically, something in my head just...
I understand. Amen. But we love you and God loves you. And there's nothing greater. Amen. Praise the Lord. Go in peace. All hearts and all minds clear.
Yes.
In Jesus' name. Amen. See you again soon.
That's good. I'll be back when it's safe. But if I have to stay with
him,
you stay with
him. Okay, let us know. Let Sister Jessica know or have Brother Jesse call me.
Okay.
Amen. Bless y'all. Y'all have a good day.
Wait, we'll let you call, Pastor.
Okay, I'll get you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Good night. Praise the Lord.